Now we also have Kimberly Williams that is backstage. Are you ready, Kimberly? Yes, ma'am. All right, I'm going to bring you on so that you can introduce your Kimberly is going to do a poem for us, right? So you can introduce your poem. Hello, Kimberly. How are you?
Hi, good afternoon. I'm great. This has been amazing. And just kudos to you and the entire team for putting this together. It's
Awesome. Thank you. Trust
been
me, it takes
dope.
a village to put this together, and in a village it definitely has been. So
No. It's definitely been great. You probably saw me backstage because I muted myself because I was back here jamming and singing to the songs myself and trying to. A little salty, I couldn't do the Family Feud. I was like, I know Black TV moms. But
awesome.
honored
Yep.
to be
I mean, this is
here.
something that we do. I mean, we are an event planning company and we pride ourselves on doing things for the community, similar to that. So, this is nothing that's new for us. We do everything that we are showing you here are things that Umoji Events does. So, thank you. I'm glad that you are enjoying it and having fun. And I know you want to hurry up and get on so you can join some more games as well. But we want to open the floor for you and welcome you. So, thank you for joining us.
Thank you guys. And I guess, should I start now?
Yep, you have the floor.
Great. So thank you guys and happy Juneteenth weekend to everyone. And today I will be sharing a bit of a piece called Because We'll Laugh and Sing a Little. Typically, I would have done this, like it would have been my voice behind a video presentation. So bear with me as I also direct myself on the camera. Because we'll laugh and sing a little. Sojourner Truth once said, "Life is a hard battle anyway. If we laugh and sing a little as we fight the good fight of freedom, it makes it all go easier. I will not allow my life's light to be determined by the darkness around me." Union Major General Gordon Granger, June 19th, 1865. The people of Texas are informed that, in accordance with a proclamation from the Executive of the United States, all slaves are free. This involves an absolute equality of personal rights and rights of property between former masters and slaves, and the connection heretofore existing between them becomes that between employer and hired labor. The freedmen are advised to remain quietly at their present homes and work for wages. They are informed that they will not be allowed to collect at military posts and that they will not be supported in idleness either here or elsewhere. This good fight of freedom is a collective responsibility. None of us are free until we're all free. So today, the people of Brooklyn and all through the United States are informed that, in accordance with the spirit of those who were still enslaved in Galveston, Texas, until June 19th, 1865, and their descendants who have preserved the joy of that day to this very moment, we still have a fight to uphold. And as long as we still have a fight to freedom, we will laugh, ha, and lift every voice and sing. Lest our souls, drunk with the wine of the world, forget. This involves an absolute equality of personal rights, he said, but the relationship cannot be simply transformed to one of employer and hired labor. Freedom exists in being simply more than vessels of toil. So, ha, we'll laugh, and our fight requires us to sing. Garvey told us to emancipate ourselves from mental slavery, and it clicked when Marley added with his signature lilt that none but ourselves can free our mind. We'll sing a song of freedom and redemption as we take what's been ours the whole time. The arenas we assert ownership over include the mental, the physical, the economic, and the political, the meanings of which will be defined only by us. We'll laugh. And we'll sing to make it all go easier. Sing a song, it'll make your day. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. We laugh as we claim our freedom, but not on your terms. This freedom is our liberation. We wage war for those today that have still not heard of their freedom. We wage war for the ones up north in the legal slave-holding union states where slavery was not outlawed by President Lincoln's fickle emancipation proclamation. It was only proclaimed over lands whose control was still in contention. We wage war for those who remained enslaved legally after the war's end, in America still yearning to be made great. We'll laugh and sing a little. We laugh and eat well and grow strong because we know the hurt in the song when we too sing America. We'll claim our freedom for those who heard the order, fought in the wars, and whose bodies and lives were still held in bondage for yet another 100 years through routine debt. We claim freedom for those today who still don't have their freedom and fight to liberate them, because even as we acknowledge the numbers, 13 free, 14 men, 15 vote, we the people know the constitutional elevators have special clauses for the 13th floor. We'll laugh and sing a little. Sojourner said that our life's light can't be determined by the darkness. So let's have our kiki. Can somebody, anybody, sing with me a Black girl's song? Can you race with destiny for that one moment in time when we'll be free? Can I get a window seat? Can you hear me sing freedom? Freedom, where are you? Because I need freedom too. We'll laugh and sing a little. And ooh, baby, we'll continue to signify. Joke's actually on you, ha! You can't steal my joy or sing my pain. Ooh, ooh, ah, ah, but you can't do it like me. Can't liberate like me. We come united and we come loudly in complete defiance of the orders to remain quietly at home. We pass your military post and take it straight to the fight. We will not align ourselves with the principles that we suggest, that suggest that we will simply work for wages at your whim and fancy. We refuse, we refute a system that defines our rest as idleness. So we celebrate this day. We marvel at our ancestors. We revel in Black joy. We continue to march on. And until victory is won, we'll laugh and sing a little. Thank you.
I got to unmute myself. Okay. Well, wow. Thank you so much. That was so powerful. It's so funny. You definitely brought in some of my son's favorite songs. I heard you mention his favorite song is the Kiki. So that was such a blessing. Thank you. Can you talk to us a little bit about what the inspiration was behind that and why you kind of put that together for us?
So I don't know when Juneteenth came into my consciousness. It's not something that I can remember like not knowing about and then all of a sudden having this awareness of. But over the years, the way that I've acknowledged Juneteenth has changed and technology has all changed. So a few years ago, I just like, it's gonna sound silly, a really nice picture of myself and my friends. And somebody had made a comment to me that weekend, oh, Kim, this is Kim. Kim stays woke. In the picture, my eyes are open and my friend's eyes are closed. So I was just like, this is hilarious. But it was also a moment of joy. And I felt that the idea of being woke had gotten to be, you know, so overcomplicated and just people were missing the idea that, you know, you could have joy in these moments in life. So I started looking for quotes and people who I could resonate with. And looked towards, you know, some of the female ancestors who were abolitionists as well, because I knew what to the American slave was the 4th of July, you know, like clockwork. But I was like, Sojourner Truth's, I saw the shadow to support the substance always stuck with me. So I was like, what else did, you know, Sojourner say? And I found that quote that, you know, it's a long fight. And if you laugh and sing a little, it makes it a little bit easier. So I threw that up on Instagram a few years ago with this picture of my friends. It was completely silly in a random moment, but that's what the connection was for me. And that's always stayed with me. So as I was working on this piece, that's what was in my mind. Like, it's a long fight. And with all the events of the last month where people seem to be having this massive awakening and this large come to moment, we have to realize, you know, it's a marathon, not a sprint. We're not going to solve everything in the next 2 weeks. It's not going to be solved with, you know, the next election even. But if we want to persevere and if we want to make sure that we're able to stand through this fight, we have to find those moments to laugh and sing a little. And a lot of our laughter and songs can be born out of pain, but you need that release. So that's where it came from.
Wow, thank you. You know, it's so powerful. And just hearing, you know, I feel like everyone who's kind of got on today had very similar sentiments. You know, it's like, you know, slavery wasn't a day. So, you know, us getting over the effects of slavery is not going to be a day either. But I definitely appreciate you. That was powerful. That hit me to my core. I definitely hope that we can cut this up and replay it on our page so that we can reshare it. I hope we have your permission to do so.
You have my permission.
But this is definitely awesome. Well, thank you. Thank you so much.
No, thank you guys. We look forward. And thank you guys.
Yeah, we're looking forward to it. Awesome. Thank you. I hope you continue to stay on and you get to jump into some of the vendor spaces and some of the presentations. We'll be here until 6 o'clock. Okay. And you have been a blessing to us. And we thank you for that.
All right. Take care. And I'll definitely be, I'll be staying with you guys on Facebook.
Awesome. Thank you. All right. Bye.
Bye.